Good morning. My name is Ejike Kanife, and this is Technext. Over the past few weeks, there have been situations with the government, the Lagos State government, and Uber and taxify drivers. And this situation has led to something which we see the Eco Cab coming up as a new alternative to Uber and the other e-hailing apps. So with me here is a man who has been in the eye of the storm. He is the CEO of Eco Cab. His name is Shevin Cole. Welcome to Technext, Mr. Shevin.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, so I'm going to go straight to the point.
Okay.
First, between us, there is something which has been going on social media, and of course, with the negotiators generally. Okay, so some people think you're actually related to Governor Sanwo-Olu of Lagos. So tell us now, are you related to Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu in any way, maybe a family member or a relative?
So honestly, between you and I, if I were, I would not be here.
Okay.
Of course. So absolutely not. I am not in no way related to the governor.
Wow, that's good. Okay, so actually I believe in competence. I believe our competence should define us.
Definitely.
Not who we know, not the barons or whoever we know.
Definitely.
So based on that competence, I think a lot of Lagosians have something they think about Eco Cab. They feel like okay, for one, you're up. They've made a lot of negative reviews on the app, even though we experienced a lot like a hike in the downloads and everything. But they've made a lot of negative reviews, and people feel like okay, if they want to use a service, they want to get a e-hailing cab, and then they book for it, and they see one of these babas with their taxis, and that they probably don't want to go with that. Coupled with the fact that there are some estates which these taxis can't really enter. And then a lot of people feel like these taxis actually hike their prices. So I don't know, do you think that having these taxis on your platform is the way forward?
Okay, thank you. So here's the thing, a lot of that has been so much misinformation, right?
Okay.
First of all, that app was put there for the pilot testing,
okay.
Right? And that has been pulled down. It was just to test them for the functionality of the application, doing the pilot testing to see whether there are any issues that the drivers could experience, so we could iterate on the fly to be able to solve that. So of course, that's not the app that's going to be launched, right? The app that's going to be launched is going to be a good app, a standard app that of course could make everyone happy. So aside from the app, one, the people that the drivers of the yellow taxis,
okay,
that are going to be you're going to be seen on the Eco Cab platform and not the babas.
Thank you.
Right. Yellow taxis in Lagos are 7,500 strong, right? But we did not go for the whole 7,500. We went for the ones that are technologically savvy. So that's a reduced number until we could onboard those that meet our specifications, right? That meet our standards. Of course, we are aware of the competitive landscape, aware of the quality of services, especially when it comes to driver experience that is currently being onboarded into the ecosystem. So of course we cannot come with that generation of drivers. We cannot do that. So the drivers that are on the Eco Cab platform are not the babas, right? They are people that one thing we did was training. So yeah, we're not just saying okay, you know what, yellow taxi, come on the Eco Cab platform. No, we did intensive training all through last year. So we trained the ones that we knew that we could train, and the technologically savvy ones, the ones that could upgrade the apps. And of course, that was part of the reasons why we did the pilot testing. And also not just training, we did a lot of cultural orientation, reorientation, of course, because you know, there's a generation, right? And the new model here, the new ride hailing model here, a lot goes into a lot of drivers' sensitization goes into the customer journey map, the customer's experience. So we did a lot of reorientation for that. That look, things cannot be done the old way. Things have to be done the new way. You understand? So those are things that you were not featured on Twitter, right?
Yeah.
But now here am I telling you that we did a lot of trainings, we did a lot of cultural reorientation, and moving forward, we are even going into partnerships, right, to educate our drivers even on the issues of sexual. You get, which even currently right now, even with what you have, the services you have, that's a lot of problems, because we see all those reports where female is sexually harassed, and what have you, even down to being raped. So that is how far we're ready to raise the bar, especially in the areas of things like that. So these are things that we have done, and we are working on, like I said, right, iterating on the fly. So of course we are open to doing better.
So how many drivers do you have on your platform now?
Presently we have 1,000 drivers that we're ready to deploy. And mind you, not just yellow taxis, like we've always tried to correct. EcoCab is a platform that is not limited to yellow taxis.
Okay.
It is also offering the private cars, exactly what our competitors are offering at the moment. So we took it a step further, not just private cars, but also traditional taxis. And it is not, this is not limited to yellow taxis. Tomorrow the red cabs can come on board. Next tomorrow the metros can come on board. This feeds back, way back into our engagements with the regulators, right? To build a kind of mobility as a service platform, right? That integrates players on through one app. So instead of you to have multiple apps on your phone, you're just going to have one app, and from that app you can hail different ride sharing apps. So what we're trying to achieve with that is that, okay, do you know what, because as a time we're engaging the regulators and the first players, one of the problems was they could not afford to develop these apps. But you know, okay, do you know, we're going to develop it for you, come on our platform. So we help you to handle that technological side so that you could focus on things like bettering customer experience, right? You don't have to compete on everything. You don't have to compete on technology, also compete on user experience and all that. We would help you with the technology side so that you could have more time, more resources that you could deploy to bettering user experience. So that's what, so it's not limited to yellow taxis. So we have some numbers of yellow taxis and also private cars that are not under the yellow taxi brand. So this is another view that is not really being pushed out there.
Okay, well, that's good. So a lot of people are of the opinion that EcoCab is a government initiative, that it has a government nucleus, but that you and your company are just a face with which they are pushing to people to become something like a people-centric one. How do you respond to such people?
Yeah, well, honestly, we totally understand. Right, but we believe that depends on the lens through which you view it, right? So yes, it has the nucleus of the government, right? And why is that so? You see there's a lot of education that has to go back online, right? A lot of people need to be educated. Now what I mean by that, not on a condescending tone, what I mean by that is, first of all, before you even understand EcoCab or Eco in the name EcoCab, you have to go back to the history of the taxi industry. A lot of people, even current mobility players, have no idea of the history of the Lagos taxis. These yellow taxis were the like foremost brand, right, that the taxi industry is leveraging on today. They were the first partners when it comes to anything taxi in Lagos State, even down to Governor Lateef Jakonde, right? And down to Tinubu, down to Fashola, when they were privatized and given their colors. Most Lagosians, most people on Twitter don't even know that yellow was not the first color they were given. They were given yellow, they were given blue, right? But still, even while given their colors, they were made private, right? But of course, the name, because they were like the foremost, they now became the Lagos State Taxi Association and Cab Operators, right? So of course they have the Lagos State in their name, but they are private. And that was done in good faith. So every successive government has supported the Lagos State Taxi and Cab Operators Association. It is business partnership. But doesn't mean that it is the Lagos State government that owns these people. And you know, I saw something on Twitter as well. It said, look at the Lagos State emblem on the... You see, that's another ignorance. Because why I said that is that that is what is called the vehicle badge, and it's going to be coming on every player. Every single mobility player is going to have that badge. So probably when that happens, we will now ask, okay, are you being owned by Lagos State? Because now you're having this badge.
Okay, so in other words, you mean that even Uber
and
Cabify would have to have this badge?
They are aware, and they have accepted, and they have agreed to have the badges. So every player is going to have a badge. Painted yellow or private, whatever color your car is, you are going to have that badge on your car. That is coming out in the new license regulation. And that is not us, that is the regulation. Do you understand? So then back to the echo. Now, since for the fact that these are the first guys that basically give birth to the taxi industry, of course they have some benefits. They have some, what I call them, they have some benefits. Because you see, another thing that people don't understand is they are part of the culture. The yellow taxis are part of the culture. You go to a time, they even coined them Okwashewo. How many people know about that? You get, they are part of the culture. So Lagos State government has to support them. They are not going away. They have to support them, right? So now they come up with an app through partnerships, and it's called EcoCab, right? It is basically, let me even tell you how we came about the idea. Okay, do you know what? We are building this thing, right? And of course, it's bringing together the mobility players in Lagos. So let's go with the Eco. I saw a tweet, right? And the tweet was like, we tried to start an Eco Bet company, and the Lagos State government said we should kind of move Eco. So how come they gave these guys? Look, that is you. Bet. That is what you wanted to start. It has nothing to do. This is, we are supporting the culture. And that is why we believe that the government supported us, and not for a day had a problem with us using the Eco Cab. And guess what? We are replicating this in other states. So probably when you see IB Cab, maybe you say that belongs to the Lagos State government, and you see Enugu Cab, and that is the vision we're getting. They're already in talks with this government. Yes, we're in talks with the government of Enugu, we're in talks with the government of Oyo State. So we're doing this to give the traditional, that's the point that has been missed in all this, to give these traditional players a fighting chance. Right? Even if we cannot level the competitive landscape, we are giving them a fighting chance. So this is not about one person's company or government. No, this is about giving, because of course, let's go back to even 2015. All around, it was a global thing. Even in London, the traditional cab operators protested. Everybody protested this technology, and we're like, look, instead of protesting the technology is here to stay. What do you do? Leverage the technology and let us be the people that will help you. Simple, win-win situation. And that's what we've done here. This has no government backing. I even saw something on Twitter that whether they're a powerful person in the government, but this is totally not. It's own bias. But this is the government. We are business partners to the regulators, and we saw the need to have an intentional and deliberate collaboration with the regulators. We don't have shame to say that. That's just business 101.